Hi everyone, and welcome to today's latest mix-up video from Monster Hunter World. Today's set is going to be focused on the Lunastra Galea Rune Greatsword, a greatsword that is the number one ideal Lunastra Greatsword to pick out of the following three if you care more about the extra damage and better jewel slots made available for you. So the Galea Rune Greatsword is a Rare D8 sword which has 912 attack, which equates to 290 raw, so it's going to hit hard, but not as hard compared to the Withering Ignition Greatsword, which has a higher attack value compared to the Galea Rune Greatsword. It also has two level 2 jewel slots for wider customization, a good portion of white sharpness, 210 blast status, and the built-in haste and recovery skill, which works great when it activates, but not something that worthwhile to fully maximize around for, especially for a greatsword, but nonetheless it's still a great skill to have. It's a rather super weapon to use for those in the higher rank, because it is a great side weapon to use for its personal damage, mainly around his true charge attacks, and if you were to focus more on min-max around the greatsword with its varied but balanced stats, then this is the ideal weapon to go for, unless you want to go with the sticks version so you don't have to sharpen so much. However, the trade-off for this is the lower raw threshold, which to me for a weapon that has only 190 raw, without no buffs or further armor skills attached, it still hits pretty hard if you were to do a full true charge attack. But not as hard as if you were going to use the Withering Ignition, for example, which reigns supreme for its attacks and raw when utilized properly. Now of course this isn't a fair comparison to make, since both weapons are geared towards two different playstyles, and the Ignition at the current moment is the only greatsword in game that easily beats out all the other greatswords because of its unique stats. But a slightly fair comparison to the weapon would be the Magda Protestas, I believe I said it right, 2 greatsword, which is a very much near identical weapon to the Ruin, with a few alterations. For starters, this greatsword has 1056 attack and 220 raw, which beats the Ruin straight away through sheer raw damage, but has minus 20 affinity because of its high raw, which is considered a trade-off for all high damage weapons. It also has 1 level 2 jewel slot compared to the Ruin 2 level 2 jewel slots, 420 blast status, and has near considerably low green sharpness, which, although it can reach blue with handicraft, is considerably gimped out because of this low feature of it, which makes the Galea Rune Greatsword a bit more powerful in the long run because of its white sharpness, and also because the sharpness multiplier that overall affects a weapon's damage, where white sharpness gives you a 1.32 multiplier, and blue only gives you a 1.28 multiplier. So you can generally see that, of course, white sharpness is going to come out on top compared to the blue. But overall, for a small comparison of the two, both weapons do near identical damage if the same skills and armor used to compare the two is used, which is why I recommend this weapon, since it's not too far off from the Galea Ruin and a super weapon for those that don't have time or can't get the Lunastra Greatsword, although it lacks the freedom that the min-max option the Galea Ruin offers. But I guess for a greatsword that has high raw and damage alone, you take what's given and work from there to improve upon it. So the set I had in mind was to focus on increasing its overall damage with the usual jewels that would use for building around the greatsword, so the standard attack up, affinity up, etc. Although because of the armor used, it leaves me with room to add in quality of life skills for myself as well, so I don't have to focus purely on damage because the amount of damage I have overall on the set is pretty substantial enough. So firstly we have attack boost 4, which increases our attack and base roll by a certain amount, while also giving you 5% affinity. Next we have critical I4, which gives you 50% affinity via jewels and chest piece, but could increase even more if I swapped out my waist for the judging waist, which would easily allow me to reach max level for the skill. Next we have critical boost 3, which helps with increasing our critical chance damage upon critical hits. Weakness exploit 3 for the plus 50% affinity per monster's weak points. Focus 3 to help with allowing us to do our true charge attacks much faster than normal. Handicraft 3 to add on another plus 30 sharpness to our weapon. Although this can definitely be swapped for something like a weakness exploit charm or any other skill charm you think benefits you, as the weapon already has good sharpness. Then you can swap the legs out for the Lunastra legs for the two jewel slots and add in the missing tenderizer jewel and then maybe a sharp jewel as well if you have it. Next we have blast attack 2 for the extra blast build up, maximum might 2 for the plus 20 affinity for our weapon, and lastly haste and recovery, which is the extra skill that comes along with the Lunastra greatsword. Overall, this will equal to 1042 attack, which equates to 270 raw, including power talon and power charm added, 403 defense, 90% affinity, and 240 overall blast status. Now, with all the following skills and jewels attached to this set, you have a set capable of reaching 800 plus range for damage upon true charge attacks, which is a very healthy number for all true charge greatsword playstyles to ideally reach. Now, add in the fact that you can trigger your blast status for an extra 120 flat damage, and you'll be downing and destroying monsters' health within only a few hits, if the blast status actually triggers, of course. Could we reach higher and aim for that 900 plus ranges? Of course. You just need to sacrifice the two bomber jewels and your charm for a attack up boost skill, and then drink a demon drug, etc., for a mighty big push for damage. But what we have here though is substantial at best, which I personally like since you're given a lot of freedom to build around the set how you like, and yet, you won't be that gimped down for overall damage if you want to add more defensive skills, for example. It's not of course going to be the go-to weapon for everyone in terms of pulling off over 900 to 1000 plus in damage in one go, but it's an incredibly useful set if you want to see how well this weapon fares in endgame. And let me tell you, it fares pretty damn well against any monster you face, as long as you're hitting the main weak point, of course. But that comes to the end of the video. I do hope you enjoyed the content. If you enjoyed it, then do leave a like, a sub, and do also press the bell button to stay always updated to when I upload, as I would appreciate a lot if you do. But like always, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again soon.